Hello, Glinchabergs! Welcome once again to my channel. This is Sir Job and welcome to Sir Job TV. Para sa lahat po ng mga new explorers at newly discovered pa lang po ang aking channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell for you to be updated with my future videos. So for this morning, I am super excited to continue the discussion under MELC number 7 in Understanding Culture, Society, and Politics. So our topic for this morning is all about non-state institutions. Welcome to my video number 73. So good morning once again, Golden Chubbergs. Welcome once again to another episode of our daily vlog here po sa aking YouTube channel. Under with our 365 Circle Project here sa aking YouTube channel. So sa lahat po ng mga patuloy na sumusuporta at nanunood po sa aking mga published videos, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. So once again, I would like to remind that our discussion for this morning is all about the non-state institutions. Okay, but before we have to continue the discussion, allow me first to emphasize to you the learning competency of this particular lesson. So our target for this morning is to differentiate functions of non-state institutions in society. So what is really non-state institutions in the very first place? Non-state institutions, or also called non-state actors, is broadly defined as international actors. Okay, take note of that. Pag sinabi natin non-state institutions, also called din po ito as non-state actors, as or defined as international actors, who are largely or completely autonomous. Highlight, completely autonomous from the state, emanating from civil society, market economy, or political opportunity. So yun po ang ibig sabihin pag sinabi nating non-state institutions, largely or completely autonomous from the state. So one of it is the bank. So what is bank in the very first place? Remember, in a certain society, very important po ang role ng bank in the development of almost all aspects of human endeavor. So what is really the bank in the very first place? Bank is a place where people deposit or save their money with corresponding interest on a given period of time. So ang role ng bank is to deposit or to save ng mga if you have your money, so you have to deposit your money in the bank, okay? And expected that there is an interest in a given period of time. It lends money both the public and the private organizations. So ang role po ng bangko is not only to lend money to the private institutions, okay, but also to the public organizations. The government borrows money from the bank to finance its projects, okay? Ang role, bakit kailangan manghiram ang bank, ang government sa bank, in order to finance the projects na gagawin, okay? While private organizations and individuals borrow money to finance their business and other personal needs. Like for example, you want to make a business. Okay, so nanghiram ka ngayon ng pera sa banko in order for you to start with your business. But accordingly, hindi po advisable, or it is not encouraged that people will have to borrow money from the bank just to make a business. If you really aim to create a business, it's very nice na inipon mo yung pera in order for you to come up that certain amount for your capital to start. But the role of the bank, according to the definition, okay, especially sa mga private mga institutions and in individuals also, nagpapahiram po ng pera si banko in order to start a business for this particular group of people. Example includes Banco de Oro, Bank of the Philippine Islands, Metro Bank, Rural Banks, and etc. So ito po yung mga banko that usually nating hinihiraman ng pera. Almost all the cities in the countries, meron pong mga branches ang mga bankong ito. But in-search ko kagabi, because I want to know the status of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas when it comes to to this particular non-state institutions as a concept. So accordingly, the Banco Central ng Pilipinas or the BSP is the Central Bank of the Republic of the Philippines. It was established on July 3 of 1993 pursuant to the provisions of the 1987 Philippine Constitution and the new Central Bank Act of 1993. The BSP took over the Central Bank of Philippines, which was established on January 3 of 1949 as the country's central monetary authority. So pinaka-center po sa lahat ng mga bangko sa Pilipinas, pinaka-center po ang Banko Central ng Pilipinas. The BSP enjoys fiscal and administrative authority from the national government in the pursuit of its mandated responsibilities. Highlight natin dito, administrative authority. So even po si Banco Central ng Pilipinas is meron po siyang administrative autonomy from the state. The next one, aside from bank, we have here the corporation. Corporation is the company or group of people authorized to act as a single entity and recognized as such in law. Usually, corporations operate as stock corporations where ownership is through stockholders, okay, who own particular shares in the company. So ano nga ba ang nature ng isang corporation? So the question is, how many corporators must organize a corporation? That's basically the question. Okay, accordingly, to form a new domestic corporation under the revised corporation code, two or more persons, but not more than 15, may organize themselves and form a corporation. Okay, but to justify the number of qualifications of incorporators, here, sa revised code, naka-state, okay, klarong-klaro, any number of natural persons, not less than 5, okay, not less than 5, but not more than 15, all of legal age and a majority of whom are residents of the Philippines, may form a private corporation for any lawful purpose or purposes. Okay? Do you get the point? Pag sinabi natin corporations, maliit lang ang members nila because not less than 5 or minimum of 5 members and maximum of 15 members. Yan po ang bumubuo ng isang corporation, basically. Again, not more than 15 and not less than 5 members in a corporation. Examples of corporation are the San Miguel Corporation and Jollibee Foods Corporation. So basically, mga famous po ito ng mga corporations. So aside from corporation, we also have here cooperative. Okay, cooperative or co-op refers to an autonomous association whose membership is voluntary. Highlight natin, voluntary. It's up to you if you want to join. Toward the attainment of common economic, social, and cultural needs or aspirations. A cooperative is owned by its members. So lahat po ng part po ng cooperative, may-ari po kayo ng isang cooperative na yan. Once you're a member, you are also an owner for that particular cooperative. So examples are credit cooperative, consumer cooperative, electric cooperative, housing cooperative, workers cooperative, agricultural cooperative, and general cooperative. So napakarami pong co-op na pwede nating salihan. If you want to invest money, if you want to loan something, like for example, mga appliances, nandyan po yan sa cooperative. Pinaka-famous natin na credit cooperative, ang tinatawag nating First Community Cooperative or yung FICO, okay? Which a lot of people are being part of that kasi napakarami na po talaga ng branches ng FICO all over the Philippines. So yan po, credit cooperative po ang FICO. So how many members are in cooperative? Okay, kasi kanina, didiscuss natin sa corporation, na minimum of 5 members and a maximum of 15. Now, pagdating dito sa cooperative, a minimum of 10 members, okay, are required to form a cooperative society. Minimum of 10 members. The Cooperative Societies Act do not specify the maximum number of members for any cooperative society. So meaning to say, unlike sa corporation, meron tayong tinatawag na maximum of 15 members. Sa cooperative, no. Wala pong specification as to the maximum members of a certain cooperative. Pero meron po siyang minimum of 10 members in order for you to put up or to form a certain cooperative. Do you get the point? Okay, aside from cooperative, we also have a trade union or labor union. Is an organization of workers. Pag sinabi kong trade union or labor union, is an organization of workers whose main objective is to protect the welfare of its members. Okay? Its purpose is to collectively negotiate employers for better compensation, benefits, safety standards in the workplace. So ito naman po ay naka-focus doon sa mga workers, no? They negotiated yung mga employers on how to give proper compensation to all their employees, okay, in that particular situation. Or yung mga safety standards that would take care of all their employees in that particular manner. Okay, ito po ang focus ng trade union or labor union as an organization. Just to name a few, in the Philippines, these national federations are Trade Union Congress of the Philippines or the TUCP and the Kilosang Mayo Uno or the KMU. So yan po ang mga examples ng tinatawag nating trade union or labor union existing here in the Philippines. So we also have the presence of the transnational advocacy groups. Okay, ano ba ang transnational advocacy groups? Are involved in social advocacy to promote principled causes, okay, ideas and values. Their goal is to give the powerless a voice in the domestic and international lawmaking body. So transnational advocacy, they have to give voice to the voiceless people, okay, especially in the international lawmaking body or in the international arena. Ang goal nila is mag-connect. That is why they also touch the culture of different countries, of different group of people from the rest of the group. Inaalam po nila, pinag-aralan po nila ang different cultures in order for them to understand freely kung ano ang mga nangyayari in that particular system. Common social advocacies include human rights, consumer rights, women's rights, environmental issues, and international peace. In the Philippines, we have Human Rights Watch is very active in the human rights and peace issues. We also have development agencies. What is development agencies? Are committed, dedicated to distributing aid. These agencies are present in developing countries. Pag sinabi kong developing countries, these are the third world countries, okay? And Philippines is part of that circle. Yung third world countries or tinatawag nating mga developing countries. Challenged by security conflict, food shortage, climate change, financial instability, and others. So ito po ang nagbibigay ng support. Ang development agencies po ang nagbibigay ng support sa mga developing countries or third world countries in the world. In terms of, again, security conflict, food shortage, climate change, financial instability, and other problems na haharapin po or kinakaharap ng isang bansa. Some of the prominent development agencies in the Philippines are the following. First, we have United States Agency for International Development. And we also have Australian Agency for International Development. And we also, the third one is the Japan International Cooperation Agency or the JICA. So yun po ang mga development agencies na tumutulong po sa mga third world countries in order for them to survive. Accordingly, aid can be subdivided into two categories, namely humanitarian aid and development aid. Ano ang ibig sabihin ng humanitarian aid? Humanitarian aid, which refers to Emergency relief efforts in response to disasters. Okay, yan po ang tinatawag nating humanitarian aid. On the other hand, meron din pong development aid or tinatawag nating foreign aid aimed at helping countries to achieve sustainable economic growth. So let's proceed with our discussion on the concept of global organizations. So when we say global organizations operate in the development of the entire country. So kanina po yung diniscuss ko sa inyo about development agencies, nakafocus po ang kanilang attention sa mga third world countries or developing countries. But this time, here's a global organizations operate in the development of entire country. Okay, they are the funders and donors. They operate by giving loans or grants to other countries to be used for development. Okay, in the onslaught of COVID-19, nung umatake po ang COVID-19 dito sa ating bansa, the Philippines was granted a loan by the World Bank to be used by the pandemic. So malaki na po ang utang natin before the pandemic sa World Bank. Ngayon, nung pumasok ang pandemic, mas nadagdagan po ang utang ng Pilipinas sa World Bank. So ito po yung mga usual na inuutangan ng mga bansa. Okay, the World Bank, okay, or the WB, the International Monetary Bank or the IMB, and the Asian Development Bank or the ADB. So, dito po usually nangungutang ang mga bansa when it comes to problems na i-encounter nila mismo sa kanilang country. Okay, but if we are going to analyze, ngayon po kasing pandemic, almost all the countries were affected. That is why mahirap talagang magbigay ng tulong ang mga first world countries to the third world countries in today's times, because even po yung mga first world countries were also affected by this particular pandemic. So napakahirap po talaga ng sitwasyon ngayon. So again, in the onslaught of COVID-19, nadagdagan na naman po ang utang ng Pilipinas sa World Bank. So now let's proceed with our discussion on the international organizations. Pag sinabi kong international organizations are organizations with international membership, scope, or presence. The two main types are the following. Okay, the first one is international non-governmental organizations or INGO, non-governmental organizations or NGOs that operate internationally. Example, International Committee of the Red Cross. This is famous. The second one is international governmental organizations or IGOs. These are organizations that are made up primarily of member states. Example, the United Nations or the UN. We are being part of this. 1946 part na po tayo ng United Nations. So, ito po ang tinatawag nating international organization. Still, ang focus nila is organizations with international membership, scope, or presence. So, part po, like for example, United Nations, ang Philippines po is part po ng United Nations right after we were given independence from the hands of the Americans. So, part na po tayo ng United Nations. So, we are or we can avail everything here sa international or benefits coming from the international organizations. So that will be all for this morning. I hope you learned something from this video, and I hope that you will share this video to your friends and to anybody else that you think nangailangan ng video na ito. Asahan niyo po that Sir Job TV will continue to discuss more meaningful discussions, especially in the field of social sciences. Thank you once again for watching. Bye-bye!